in the applications of solar thermal energy, right? So air heaters are the devices to heat air for various purposes, which can be for heating the room, drying something, vegetables or spices, or just if you need hot air, you can use solar air heaters. The input energy is solar energy and air will be passed on through the collector. So you will see the different configurations. So one of the major applications of solar air heaters is to dry spices. Okay, it is very efficient. It is proven to be very efficient when compared to open solar dry, because the drying of the spices are taking place inside a closed console. Solar air heaters are of various types depending on the direction of airflow, construction, as well as the application. So there are single pass, double pass, depending on the airflow, whether it is single, is I mean air is passing in a single line or double line, or multi-layered air heaters, whether there are some partition in between the two passes, or recirculated type. Anyhow, we will see those types in detail. In its simple construction, this is the schematic cross-sectional view of a solar air heater. You can see there is a supporting stand. Okay, then in the, there is an insulation on the top. You can see a transparent cover or glazing or a glass cover, and you have an absorber plate. Below the absorber plate, instead of, in the case of a liquid flat plate collector, you had tubes in which water or any other liquid was flowing, but here there is a passage for air. Air will be letting in and going out from the top, thermosiphoning. Okay, so everything will be placed inside a casing. You can see the relative thicknesses. The insulation is pretty thick when compared to the other, the air path as well as the absorber plate and glass. So the main components, construction wise, if you see, the main components of a solar air heater are an absorber plate, as you have seen in the previous diagram, one or more channels, but I have shown in the previous slide was a single channel air heater. Insulation, one or more transparent covers, right? So when air is flowing like this from the bottom and heated up and going through the top, right, this is natural convection. No blower or fan, no forced convection is employed. If you want to flow the air forcibly, you may have to use a blower. These are the different types of solar air heaters in the first category, depending on the air channel flow configuration. How many channels for airflow? That is the first classification: single flow, single pass, double flow, single pass, single flow, double pass, and single flow, recycled double pass. So this is the first one, single flow, single pass. This is a glass plate. Okay, this is the airflow channel. Three is the, this black color is the absorber plate. Four is the insulation. Solar insulation, solar radiation will be falling on the glass. So glass will be transmitting that to the airflow channel, I mean to the absorber plate. Absorber plate will get heated up. It will re-radiate whatever energy is falling on the absorber plate. Obviously, glass will not allow the long wave radiation to escape out, so that entire energy will be trapped inside due to greenhouse effect, that will be transferred to this airflow, to the air, right? So there is a only a single flow as well as single pass for air. That's why it is termed as single flow, single pass. Now double flow, single pass. Air is flowing in a same direction but through two channels, through the upside as well as downside of the absorber plate. On the up and down of the either sides of the absorber plate, air is allowed to flow in the same direction. There is only difference from the previous one. Single flow, double pass, the third category in the first configuration. Single flow, double pass. You can see here, air is letting in through the upper side of the absorber plate and coming back through the bottom side of the absorber plate. there is no outlet here. Here it is closed, but it is going out through the same side. Single flow recycled double pass. You can see here, instead of the closed configuration here from the previous one, it is open. A certain portion of the heated air is going out, and the remaining air, a certain portion of the air, is getting mixed with the atmospheric air here and going back through the inlet through the bottom of the absorber plate. Again, it is getting mixed up with the fresh air and going in. So there is a recycling effect. That's why it is recycled double pass. Second configuration of classification is related to the air channel design. How the channel for airflow is designed. So it can be flat plate, extended surface assisted, fins, porous media. So here, the first configuration in the first category, you have seen single flow, single pass, right? So this is similar to that. Flat plate, single flow, single pass solar air heater. So flat, it is similar to flat plate character. Instead of liquid tubes, there is air pass, air flow passage or channel, a single channel. Now here in the air channel, you can see a number of protruded surfaces, number of projected surfaces, right? These are called as fins or extended surfaces. What is the need of extended surfaces? You know that convection heat transfer is directly proportional to the surface area over which the heat is flowing, right? Convection heat transfer is directly proportional to the surface area over which the heat is transferred. So whenever the surface area is increased, so here by incorporating these fins, we are actually increasing the surface area with which the air is getting contact. So surface area is increased as well as heat transfer is increased. So in order to increase the heat transfer from the absorber plate to the air, we are using these fins or extended surfaces. This is the second classification in the second category, extended surface assisted. The third one is porous media assisted. So you can see just below the absorber plate, you can see a porous media. It could be gravel, some spherical bowls. There will be some void spaces in between for the air to flow. This will be completely filled. The advantage of using this is, this porous media will be having very high heat capacity. It will store the energy from the air. So whenever air is coming from the top to bottom, this porous media is in direct contact with the absorber plate. So by convection, heat will be transferred to this porous media. So already heated air from this top passage will further heat up when it is going through this porous media. Okay, so this is the third category in the second configuration, air channel design. So in short, air heaters, solar air heaters, are devices to heat air. There are two different classifications or design based on the air channel and air number of channels or air channel design, how the air channel is designed. Okay, I hope this is clear. Then this is a kind of a newer category, old plastic air heater. Instead of metallic, there is plastic amount. Textile absorber and PVC cover are used instead of glass and metal parts. So that's all about solar air heaters. In the coming class, we will discuss about how to desalinate water using solar energy. Thank you. Please go through the each and every classifications category in detail. If you have any doubts, please revert through the group or mail. Okay, thank you.